What we were looking at is we were looking at a source for stem cells. So the placenta is a great source for stem cells. There's not a lot of ethical issues that are raised around it. And so we thought, all right, whenever we're working with hollow fiber, we want to try to recapitulate the in vivo situation as much as possible. So what we thought was, okay, let's just take a placenta. And we found that if we utilize pulsatile perfusion, we would get better perfusion of the placenta itself. So we utilized one of our duet pumps to pulsatile perfuse placenta. First, we did it with PBS, 24 hours. And, yeah, you can just hook it up to a tube and ligate it up, and you can pump things right through the placenta. It comes out the other end. So we started off with PBS, and we wanted to get rid of cord blood and the CD34. We're not interested in that. And then we take collagenase. And we circulate collagenase for an hour, and we just digest up the placenta. The idea was we wanted to get all the different cell types that were present. So we wanted to be sure to get the endothelial cells. I think they were important. We wanted to get trophoblasts. They may be in there. We want to get the stem cells. Whatever we can get, we want to get a mixed population of cells and put it into the hollow fiber bioreactor. And I've submitted this grant several times to the Maryland Stem Cell Commission, and every time it comes back saying, this is non-hypothesis-based science, and I'm here to tell you I'm a big fan of non-hypothesis-based science at times. So we took all these cells and we just dumped them into the 5KD cartridge. We wanted to enhance cell-to-cell interaction, concentrate any cytokines that the cells might be secreting. So we put it into 5KD cartridge, and then the first 3 days we would just gently flush it out to remove the non-adherent cells. Then after about a week, we started to see these red blobs, these red nodules forming on the fiber. And we had a new crop of suspension cells that were being harvested out of the cartridge. Remember, they're in a 3D environment. They're suspension cells coming out of the cartridge. So these cells are kind of small in diameter, somewhat reminiscent of Ratichak's very small embryonic-like stem cells. We take these cells that are in suspension, and we put them on a flask with 5% serum, and all of a sudden they attach to the flask and they look a lot like mesenchymal stem cells, complete with erythroid bodies forming, three-dimensional erythroid bodies. So this is kind of an interesting question that you run into if you have cells and you're not really sure what their source is. How are you going to define them? So basically what we did was just went to the freezer and took any of the markers we could find and things that we saw might be good. So we can see the different markers that we tried. And the ECS harvests are these suspension cells that are coming out of the cartridge, suspension cells. We can see they're kind of phenotypically indistinct. CD105 is going to be the highest one. That's both an MSC marker and an endothelial marker. But then we take these cells, we put them into a flask, and then 3 days later, in the presence of serum and two-dimensional non-porous plastic support, we can see that these cells are now 99% MSC positive. So another just extreme example, I believe, of just how important cell culture conditions are, how profoundly the culture conditions can affect cell phenotype and physiology. So in summary, thanks everybody for hanging in there this long. Hollow fiber bioreactors are the method of choice for the culture of 10 to the 9th to 10 to the 11th cells. It's an easy way for any lab to handle large numbers of cells. It's ideal for producing 100 mg to several grams of a monoclonal antibody, 10 to hundreds of mg of recombinant protein. The concomitant concentration of products 10 to 100 times higher than with conventional methods. And most importantly, it's the most in vivo-like method for culturing cells over long periods of time, extended periods of time, and it's also going to save you time, space, and purification costs. So it should be clear that hollow fiber bioreactors are the most evolved way of growing cells, and it's the most in vivo-like way of growing cells in the laboratory versus these other methods that are limited in their relevance to physiology depending on what it is you're doing. So thanks very much for your time.